SpotlightMediaStudios.com. Welcome to Education Unfiltered. Here is Mary Stucco.
Hello, this is Mary Stucco with Education Unfiltered, where we talk about all things higher ed. And today is no different. So today we are going to be talking to Karin Hanson, who's the Director of Employee Relations and Communications Career Services Network for Michigan State Universities. And career services need to be embedded in the student's college education. So we're going to talk about what MSU does to help the students prior to graduation. Welcome, Karin.
Thank you so much. I'm excited to be here.
We are excited. So tell me, why do students, when they go to Michigan State, why do they need to be communicating with career services, you know, especially earlier on when they're still going through school? Because I'm sure you see a lot of people who just wait until the end
right. And
like, now find me a job. So tell me a little bit about how that all should work for a student.
Exactly. You are exactly right. We do have a lot of students that wait until they are ready to either find an internship, so they think that might be towards the end of their junior year or their senior year when they're getting ready to graduate, to actually seek us out, which we're glad to see them at that point, but we truly want to start working with them as soon as they start at MSU, even that summer before they set foot on campus, either in person or virtually. So we encourage students early on to truly explore all the different options that are available to them. Most of our students actually, believe it or not, change their majors 4 times. So if you change your major 4, that's a lot of changes.
Yeah.
Within 4, 5, or 6 years in college. That's a lot to go through. So we want to ensure that they truly understand the options that are available to them early on in terms of a career and what different types of things they can be looking at, whether that's connecting with a mentor that might be in a field that they're interested in, attending a networking event, even participating in career fairs for exploratory reasons to talk to different employers and learn more about those different opportunities. But sometimes they might have absolutely no idea what they're interested in doing. And so early on, if we are able to catch them early on, we can work through career assessments with them and a lot of different ways to help them narrow down different interests, pick their major, and then narrow down into specific fields. So it's great if we can work with them early as freshmen.
That's wonderful. And I went to Michigan State and I didn't even ever think to do anything like
right.
that ahead of time, although I had internships and all that, but I did it on my own. So that's great that was a long time ago, just as a side mention there. I'm sure you've seen some changes with the pandemic. Mm-hmm. So what have you adjusted and what do you see moving forward?
That is a huge question. The pandemic actually gave us the opportunity to re-explore a lot of the things that we were doing. We were always talking about what's next for career services and what does that mean? What did the next 20 years hold for the work that we do and what does that mean for us? How should we change? And the pandemic, again, kind of forced us into making those changes quickly over the last year, which has actually been a really great thing now in hindsight. Of course, when it happened a year ago, March, we found out the morning of the day of a career fair when we had 230 employers that were setting foot on campus that we were no longer able to host that event.
Oh no!
In person, and that classes were going virtual in 2 days. So we had to immediately flip everything to a virtual format. But we moved into or creating a new website, and we called it our virtual career center. We offered our advising online, we offered our career fairs online, and we immediately started reaching out to our employers to understand what this meant for internships in the summer. Many of them, if we remember last March, a year ago March, we thought that this was only going to last a couple weeks. I know when I left campus, I thought, wow, I'll be back maybe 2-3 weeks. Longest.
Yeah.
And so we'll get this back on track, no problem. But what can we do in these few weeks to make sure students are feeling comfortable and employers are feeling comfortable? Well, as it extended, we realized that we needed to make some truly more permanent changes. So we did flip all of our events to virtual events, and we actually expanded our events for students, expanded our workshops, We increased our number of workshops that we offered to students. Our attendance actually jumped up last year. We expanded our ability to offer those advising appointments, and those numbers increased over the previous year when we were in person, which was amazing. And the year prior, we had held 41 in-person career fairs, and then this past year, we held 56 virtual fairs for students. This was great for employers as well as for students. It gave them multiple opportunities to be able to connect. We found that we were able to bring more employers virtually to campus because they no longer had to travel or think about budgets or things along those lines. It was a matter of just participating virtually with the students. So it actually ended up being a strength to be able for us to explore those options and quite frankly, get a lot better at how we offered those services virtually. So the future will certainly hold a hybrid version of our events for students, both early stage events, we were talking about those freshmen, all the way through those students that are getting ready to graduate and need to find that permanent opportunity. As we think about what we're looking towards fall, we've surveyed our students quite extensively, and over 70% of them loved the virtual fairs and the virtual events and definitely want to continue those even when in person becomes the norm again. So we're not going to let those go, but we're going to integrate those along with some in-person events, which we know will only continue to expand those opportunities for students and employers to connect and for mentoring to happen, for networking to happen, and quite frankly, for that growth all throughout their time at Michigan State.
Yeah, it's kind of nice for students, especially if they're feeling really uncomfortable, because it is uncomfortable to go into a room where you don't know people, to kind of watch it, and especially early on, to get a feel for what does it look like and how should I dress and, things like that. I know those are questions that, I would ask as a student. It's like, what do? How am I supposed to handle this? So that's kind of nice.
No, those are all great questions. I know we held a lot of workshops last year about those exact pieces, not only tutorials on how to use the system virtually and how to ensure that you have success that way, but also to your point, where do I put the camera? How do I make sure that I'm really putting my best quote unquote foot forward virtually? What do I say? Interestingly, so a lot of our networking events and our career fairs are a series of 10-minute one-on-one sessions, and students are like, oh my gosh, 10 full minutes with these employers. This is forever. But it goes so quickly.
Yes.
And so we need to do a great job educating and training the students on how to utilize those 10 minutes of staring into a camera to really sell yourself when it goes by so fast.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's one thing I was going to ask you more. Tell me a little bit about these workshops that students are able to participate in.
Our workshops range everything from the basics, right? Like how do I write an amazing resume? What do I do to set myself apart with my resume and just in general those pieces? But most importantly, it's about the workshops that are well attended are, of course, those that talk about networking, setting yourself apart with social media. That's key. Making sure that your online presence is truly projecting the right image that you want to project and that it's appropriate for the industry that you want to be in. So for a lot of those, we invite employers to participate so students can learn from the employers and, hey, what are you really looking for? We have virtual interview workshops, which are definitely well attended by the students and that they get excited about as well. And then we've had a lot of Zoom networking events where students and employers are in Zoom rooms together and they're doing some informal networking, which is quite nice.
Excellent.
So that's a lot of the workshops that we've gone through over the last year.
Sounds like great stuff. What do you see as the current job and internship outlook right now?
We have seen it's actually pretty impressive. Our jobs, so we utilize Handshake for our job postings on campus. So we can measure exact numbers of jobs in the different industries and break all that down year to year. we have seen our jobs increase. So pre-pandemic, they have risen during the pandemic, job postings over the previous year. And I do think that that is showing that we are seeing strong job growth and strong opportunities for our students, most definitely. So that's exciting because we're hearing a lot about the fact that there are a lot of people that are still out of work. But it's great to see that we have seen very, very strong strong job growth. And we actually have seen about a total year over year. So pandemic versus year prior to pandemic, about 5,000 additional jobs just for MSU students, which has been exciting to see. But we also are understanding that students need to be flexible because not all job areas are represented the same. So for example, we're just now seeing advertising agencies, you know, pick back up. So okay. Students that are looking in that type of an industry or some of the more creative industries, we're seeing a lot of those pick back up and we're seeing a lot more jobs posted, but they weren't necessarily as heavily posted during the year as they may have been previously. Whereas I know you've had guests talk about the insurance industry. The insurance industry has been booming for us. We've seen a lot of new jobs posted in that industry throughout the entire year during the pandemic.
Yeah, that was definitely, you know, good for the Lansing area because as far as I know from what I've heard from them, none of them laid people off. They just kept adding more people and they switched real quickly to, you know, at home. So that's really, you know, that's a good industry to go into if you want job security because we never know what the future holds. So
that industry did a very nice job from what I saw as well, flipping their internships and their jobs into virtual opportunities for students. And actually, a lot of companies have done an excellent job. I've been impressed with all the work that's been done to truly work with, and I understand working with their current talent, but onboarding new talent into their workplace virtually. It's been great to see all the changes that have happened versus a year ago spring when they were talking about how in the world are we going to be able to do this. And the seamlessness that they have been able to do that this year and this summer, especially for internships, has been impressive to me.
That's great. So are you seeing certain areas, do you think, in the future, like looking ahead to the future with your crystal ball, what do you think that's going to look like?
In terms of, I do think that, I mean, as we're seeing, most employers aren't quite sure exactly what the future is going to look like. So as you can imagine, we keep a pretty close pulse on the employers that we work with. We're meeting with them regularly, having constant conversations with them about what the future looks like. And a lot of them are still saying, so over half of them on our last survey, they're still saying that we aren't quite sure exactly what the future holds, but we do know that a hybrid will always be a part of something that we're doing in the future, but we're not sure exactly what that means. Many individuals are over the next few months, or many companies over the next few months, are trying to determine, can we have certain positions completely virtual, even newer positions or internships that we had never considered continuing to keep virtual in the future? And is that, quite frankly, better for our employees or our interns? And what does that mean for the organization as a whole? They're also looking at how do they embed, with a lot of people working virtually, especially interns, how do we embed, culture is such an important part of the job, especially, again, for new hires. How do we embed culture in that that new hire experience? And perhaps it's bringing students in for some things throughout that internship, but allowing them to work remotely for vast larger parts of it. Or you know, maybe it's just bringing them together a couple times during that internship piece, and or better incorporating virtual fun pieces, right? So we're seeing virtual happy hours and things along those lines have been happening quite a bit, but doing those in new and unique ways that truly engage the students so that they're not feeling like they're suffering from staring at a screen for 40 hours a week.
Do you have any just quick words of wisdom for students right now getting ready to enter the job market?
Oh, yes. My goodness. Stay flexible. I think that's the key, is flexibility. Employers are saying over and over again, it's about remaining flexible. They might need to make a change in your work situation just prior to you starting a new position, and that's okay. Remain flexible, but keep in great communication with your potential employer as well. It's okay to ask questions if you're unsure about something. If you're unsure how virtual may work or how hybrid may work, ask those questions. Mm-hmm. But keep in contact, stay flexible. I think that that's definitely the key.
It's great words of advice. Thank you, Karin Hanson from Michigan State University. We appreciate all your great thoughts. This is Mary Stuckel with Education Unfiltered. Thank you so much for today. And this podcast is sponsored by Davenport University. Have a great day. Thank you to Frank and Muth Insurance for sponsoring this episode.